Hi, well, welcome back to Steve Sheds Car Models. In this video, we're going to be doing the Mustang 1967 build your own, and we're going to be doing issues number 71 to 74. Been a while, away for a while, had my birthday, had a few little problems as well, been working. Burnt on tops of my fingers at Emirates the other week, so that's a bit painful. So we'll see how that goes with the build today. Without further ado, let's get on with it. So here we are, issue number 71. Let's have a quick look through the magazine. Shelby Cobra Daytona Coupe Mark II, quite nice. Buick Riviera GCS. Okay. I must admit, I don't read too much of the magazines. I've got all the folders up there with the magazines in, but. I don't really read a great deal of them. So, let's get into the build. So, I'm going to need the parts we had from the last build, so excuse me. One second. Let's get these parts down in our box. Let's have the engine out, because I do believe I'm going to need that. There's another piece there. I think that's it. So we just put that to one side. And let's get out the pieces. Here we go. Let's open that up. So in this episode, issue number 71, we are doing alternator, pulleys and radiator hose. So, one piece, that's a piece of plastic, more plastic, plastic and plastic. Looks like this is all plastic. These parts are definitely no more pieces left in there. Let's get our screwdriver. That's one, and I think we probably need this one as well, and that one. So I am going to put my goggles on. No, actually I might just put my glasses on. Got a little bit blurry. So, we have, in actual fact, thank you. Right, because I'm getting a lot of blur, shine, I'm going to actually put that up there. I hope you can see that, possibly, possibly not. And this way I'm not getting so much reflection off of the surface of the magazine. So we have, this is what we're going to be doing. Install care parts. So first of all, get these two parts together, which is the radiator hose. Now these just snap together apparently. Now that is a bit doing that, because it's a little bit hard on my fingers. They're absolutely chuffed, my fingers. They're burnt up. I burnt all four. Picking up a hot plate out of the hot plate. Hot plates, in a hot plate, it's going to be hot. Well, yeah. But when I work at Emma, the hot plates aren't normally that hot. But today, this one decided to be very hot. So, there's a bit of. Let's give it 1 second, because I'm going to just get a couple of my sanding sticks. Because that's a bit of a rough surface on there, and I just want to I know it's gonna dull that down, but it is a radiator. So a radiator hose isn't gonna be shiny anyway, it's gonna be quite dull. But I just wanna, in actual fact, I don't know if that's made that worse or not. Well, we'll see. But anyway, we take radiator apart, radiator, and it needs to come in at that angle, apparently. And it just, oh yeah, let's take that out because I haven't supposed to put that in yet. I just put that in there, didn't I? So there you go, radiator hose out. Next part is step 71E. Next, take the alternator, be 73, and the support, 74. Align the pin and hold as shown. Right, so you've got a flat edge there. And you can see there's a half semicircle in there with the flat edge. So that goes there. And clips in. I'm going to push that down. Yeah, there you go. So that's all clipped in. Next page. Right, okay, so now we're taking this part. And we are putting that on here like so. Clipping that in. And then we have a screw to put in. So here's the screw. Where's my blade? Here's my blade. And we are going to be putting in a MP01. Here's the MP01 screw. Let's get the mounted screwdriver. Start it off with that one and then finish with this one. At least I can use the screwdriver, okay? That was a little bit sore. So, here we have. So now we take that part, hold it like so. Is that the way that goes? I think so. Yep, on there, that looks just like that. And then we take the radiator, or the fan, shall I say, and it goes on there. Should be facing that way, yes. And now we use another MP01 screw to go right in there. Well, is this what you're going to need? A magnet screwdriver to get in there. Okay, that's a deep hole to go right down in there. Right, that's in. So let's just. Right, it says to turn the assembly over, holding the fan position and screw it with an MP01 screw. Here's how the assembly should look at the end of the stage. That's quite tight, so I'm just going to loosen that off a bit. Because I think all that is doing is just holding that in place and the fan. So I'm presuming at some point that is going to go in there like that. But we're not doing that just yet. That is this issue complete. So that was quite relatively quick and easy. So let's just put that away. And the next issue, we are doing right engine block and light switch. Ooh, means we've got a little bit of electricity. So let's get our issue. And here we are. Let's have a very quick look through the magazine. 2001 Mustang GT Bullet. Okay. Chrysler. American fire engines. I must admit, I do like American fire engines. They are pretty good, actually. Especially the big ones like this. Oh, they don't really touch much on the engines, do they? Wow. Anyway, so here we go. Up on there. And let's get our parts out. Make sure there's nothing in there. So we have this piece, electrical wire, one very small plastic piece, some screws, oh, another plastic piece. So make sure there's nothing else in there. Nope. So metal, plastic, 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 obviously screws, and then our switch. On and off switch. My looks. So. Anyway. Right, so. Let's get then our spare screws. Let's open up these MP03s. Take them out. Right. So. Well, so is that? Right. By the looks of it, that goes in there. Line the pin and post on the gas recycling filter. Now, that looks like that way around. Yep. Push it in. That looks a bit. That looks as if it's locking to me. But that is the part, that is the correct way. Because it can't be that way. That's wrong entirely. Doesn't even go anywhere near there, so yeah, it is definitely there. It does the raised part, but that bit there just looks a bit, it sits proud slightly. But according to that, that is how it goes. Right, so let's use an MP03 screw to secure that in. And of course, as soon as you pick that up, it comes out. So let's just do that again. Hold that in there. I hate that screwdriver. The only good fact is it's magnetized. No, see, that is wrong way round. Ah, it's me putting the wrong way round. Didn't I? Right, it goes in that way. And sits up proud. That's why it's for. See, I am the dealer. See, you need to read the instructions properly. Again and again. Right, so make sure you get that the right way around. And the screw goes in there, like so. Now, sorry, you probably can't see that. So the screw goes in that side, not there. I was trying to put it in there. Had the thing completely way round, wrong way round. And now, so now it doesn't knock. So when I had it that way round, it was knocking this piece of raised metal work. But now, having the right way round, it doesn't do that anymore. Okay, so now that's in. Now we cast this piece and Retrieve the engine front from stage 71 and position as shown. Doesn't go in there easily. Is that the right way around again? No, again, wrong. Read the blooming instructions properly. Right. That is as that sits now. Right, let's turn the page over. Huh? That's it? Oh god. Well, that doesn't even. Well, I'm just going to use a knife just to. Not to cut anything off, I'm just homing that in on the. Okay, so. That's not secure at all, really. In fact, it looks pretty unsecure. So it shows how the engine block should look, which it does. It's just a bit wobbly there. Well, that's how it should look according to the picture. So now we need to get the car chassis down. Just going to put that there. And we need to be doing with the wire. So it says insert the light switch into the small hole in the rear of the dashboard arrow. Oops. So I'm going to now, does it sew a particular way up? It seems to show there's one prong up there and two down the bottom, so it needs to go in way. Okay. Just need to move some things. Right, okay, so basically it wants me to use that to hold that down. Okay, right, I might just have to move this around a bit. What glass of water? I know what I can do. I can put that on there. I'm just gonna move that light a little bit. Now it wants me to use this part. To secure that down on there. So that's right. Before I do this, I'm taking these glasses off and putting these ones on. Because I can get a light in there now. You've got a light boy. Right, okay. So, screw. I'm hoping you can see this. You should be able to. Let me just turn that around a bit. In there. Well. Nope. have to be a pair of tweezers. Home. Let's not. According to that, it is in and it won't go anymore. But that's still a bit loose. Wait, so it's in there. That's a little bit of. Let's just have those off. Right, let's just bring that back in a second. Let's have a look. Okay, blah, blah, blah. Switch can go up and down. Yes, it can. And that's complete. Right, I'm going to put that back up there. Let's go look at the camera angle again. So, straight into issue 73, so still got all these parts left. So a quick glimpse through the magazine. The Shelby style Dodge Omni. Oh wow, looks horrible. What's this other one? Sorry. Chevrolet, Monte Carlo. Women, American women drivers. And into the build. Right, so let's have a look up there. I keep catching my fingers. Oh, looks like the engine block is finally coming together. So, metal, plastic, 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 screws. Nothing else in there. Okay. So, recover the engine assembly from stage 72. Yes. Slide the bar. Slide the bar on there. Okay, now we have to offer up this. Oh, this is going to be tricky. Well, it's not, it's just. Clicked in, I don't know if you heard that. Still have a gap there, but the gap there is okay. Yeah, looking good. Wow, that's probably the wrong way around, but I've just stuck it on there just to have a quick glimpse. Wow. So, pull. Next page. So we have that in, yes, that is in, and now we've got to put some screws in. Uh, Turn the assembly over and make sure that the joints are properly engaged. I can't get that any closer. All that. No, I can't get that any closer together. Well, that's still wobbly, isn't it? I'm still a little bit wobbly. But, let's see. No, it's not engaged properly at all. I don't have a big enough pair of pliers to try and push that in. There's nothing going in. So, you're just going to have to do it. Right, so, screws. Using MD06s. Anyway, right, here we go. We are just doing these two first of all. One in. Okay, that's one. Oop. It's going to be a quick stage as well. I'm not even going to get to put that piece on. Wow. So there's two screws. And now we've got third one at the top part now. I'm just going to go straight into that one. Like this. And now. One, two, three. Four. Alright, so now that's not going anywhere. Put that aside. Or radiator. That way round. This piece. Recovery radiator and insert the logs. As shown. This is how the radiator pull support should look. Here are the assembled parts. Keep your manifolds to one side to use in the future. Okay, so let's just while we're here, look, I think that is going to be looking pretty good, and then you're going to have that in there somewhere like that, I think, possibly not, I don't know, but yeah, looking quite good. You can see I've painted these and I've clear coated them so they look nice, and I reckon these manifolds are going to go in there somewhere, but we will wait to sort issues. Painted those bits gold because I saw a picture on online just to get a bit of reference, and the black just to get a little bit of a more detail on there. So let's just take that out, put that to one side, fold up. What are we doing next? Oh, we're getting some bottom plate and engine block components. So let's put that there. Oh, it's all the way back there. And here we go, 74, last issue in this batch. The Grand Am Boss 302. Oh, well, okay. Mercury Cougar Eliminator. Okay. Yeah. The Blue Ridge Parkway for bikes and cars, I suppose. Right. Okay, let's go straight in. So, last part of this four part build series. Let's get all our parts out. We are beginning, well, second week in October, so I should be getting some more parts in the next week or two. I expect it to be the latter. And then we will try and get on with that one fairly quickly. I'm getting some new bits and pieces for, I'm getting a new mount for my phone, because I'm using my phone at the moment. I will be getting a, well, I'm trying to get looking forward to save up to get a 1080 HD either webcam or a camera. So if I do the webcam, I'll be able to look down on the build, which will be a lot easier. So, right, it says, so we are going to actually put this in. Now, let's make sure we do have it the right way around. In we go. Turn that upside down. I'm going to, because I just want to protect that, because I don't want that chipping off, really. So here we go. Putting that on there. We need to have that. Oh no, one way around, look again, keep looking properly. Goes on like so. And there's no screw for that one. So now we have parts to go in there. Clip in, okay, that's fine. Now we're going to use MBO 8. MDO 8, should I say, not MPs. Just keep those separate. And we're going to put one there. And there. There's one. And two. Let's get that tied up. Secure. So now we have insert the flat end of the pressure sensor, which must be that, into that hole. So now it is flattened slightly. I need to put these down. It goes in there like so. Now that is a little bit flimsy in there, so I'm going to just put a little bit of glue in there. Not much, just a little bit. Because I don't want that falling out. I've already had parts, I've already had some parts fall off. And I might have lost one, but we'll go back into that if I'm going to try and find it at some point. So there's that. Engine block, yes, that's in. Now press the filler tube into the cap. Okay. particular way around. No. Just push that down on there. And now this, this goes in there. Again, I'm going to put a little bit of glue in there. Goes. So that's the filler tube. I mean the filler. Yeah, filler tube. Okay. Insert. Ooh. Now we have insert the end of the first recycling tube. I don't think it's gonna be that one. Must be that one. So that has to go in there. What is that? What is it? Oh, there is. Okay. So there's a little hole there. Which that goes on, and that goes in there. Really, that's not held on to anything. Insert the end of the first recycling tube into the small hole in the centre of the gearbox top. Ah, that's why. Doesn't go in there. Goes in there. Right, again, I think that needs a little bit of glue. So I'm just going to use this Tamiya extra thin. I do quite like this. It's a very good, strong glue. And it's got a very good capillary action. So you don't need much, but it will find. There we go. That should help there. Okay, so next we have the lever tube. Right, so this one comes in here. We can see that. Oh dear, let's just. This is actually quite hurting now because my fingers are quite sore. Right, so there. Okay. Where is it going there? Just goes under there. Huh? Insert the end of the second tool into the hole on the right cylinder cover. Yep. Oh. That is a bit odd. It just sits there. Doesn't decide to put it in anywhere in particular. And we've still not got the manifolds on. Wow. Well, there you have it. That's the it's very strange. Well, I'm not gluing this one in. Just in case this has to be inserted somewhere else at this end. So I'm not going to glue that one in, but we are there like so. Now let's just put that lid on. Take that away a second. So we still have our two manifolds, which I'm presuming one is going to go in there. I'm not going to force that in because I think they actually have to be forced in, so we won't do that just yet. And obviously on the other side. So what I'm going to do is put those there let's bring down the actual car and let's see if we can. Wow, there you go. There's obviously something else that needs to go there, but starting just to take shape. Let's just put that there. Well, let's just see if we can. Yes, because that will hold that up, won't it? There we go. Starting to look good. Put the engine there. Yes. I'm liking that. This will obviously just tuck down here somewhere for now. But yes. What do you reckon that actually tucks down there? Who knows? You decide. So, yep. There we go. And that will look good with the engine mount on. I'm not going to do it because now my I will break something. So yeah, there we go. Right, so there we go. That is issue 71 to 74. All done, complete. Starting to get a very good engine bay. Starting to come very along nicely. Still a long way to go. So if we're at 74, I think we've got about another 25 issues to go. So 4 months or another, best part of nearly another year. Maybe not. Well, I'm not going to work it out, can't be bothered. But yeah, still quite a long way to go. But it's done really good. I'm really enjoying it. Sorry it's been a while for this one to come out. I will try and get the next one up, hopefully within the next 2 to 3 weeks, depending on the parts coming through, how rapidly they come through. Thank you for watching. Look out for any more videos coming up. I think my next video is going to be on my Enterprise. I've got some parts for that now. I've got some LEDs which I want to show, and I can hopefully now carry on with the saucer section because I've been waiting for these for a little while. Been down to money constraints, not been able to afford to buy the parts, but now I've got them. And so yeah, that will be my next video. So look out for that one coming up soon. Thanks so much. Bye bye.